Bobby, I got to ask you a question.
Yeah.
I need you to look into your email and tell me how many emails you have in your inbox right now, sitting there.
I have 41,000.
Okay.
That's insane.
So what's up? I like emails.
Do you like having all of them there?
No, I don't. I hate them.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah.
Would you like
junky chunks?
Would you like a way to clean it up and only keep the ones you absolutely need?
I don't live in the future, do I?
Maybe we
do.
Maybe you do.
I live in the future, you think?
Yes, with this new program called Sanebox.
Sanebox?
It's called Sanebox.
Yeah.
What Sanebox does, it cleans up your email. So all those 41,000 emails you have,
yeah,
it clears out all the junk. So you keep only the important ones from your huge management, all the celebrities that email you.
So you can you say specifically what I want to keep?
Yes.
Yes.
That's amazing. There's technology that's caught up to now.
This it's called a Sanebox. So guys, what the Sanebox has, a special feature, you guys will love this. It's called the black hole.
Oh shit.
The black hole, what it does, you can take any email from any address from like a junk mail, put it in the black hole, and it will delete it forever, and you'll never receive it again from an annoying person. From that sender right there. So you're going to get it, right?
Yeah, I'm going to. Ian Edwards has a black hole, too.
Oh! But keep in mind, we're talking about Sanebox.
Yeah, Sanebox.
So guys, visit sanebox.com/TigerBelly today, and they'll throw in an extra $25 credit on top of a two-week free trial.
And good, I mean.
It's good and cheap.
And good.
Mm-hmm. So guys, once again, that's Sanebox, sanebox.com/TigerBelly. Fix your life.
And I love vegetables too. What's that other thing?
No.
We're not doing that this week. Just Sanebox this week.
Sanebox.
Can we repeat the code?
Yeah, it's sanebox.com/TigerBelly. Yeah. That's sanebox.com/TigerBelly. Guys, go clean up your emails now. Don't be a loser.
I'm Bob. Welcome to Tiger Belly, everybody. I'm Bob. We got George. We got Bryce in the room. We got my girlfriend, Khalyla. And we got Gilbert. And we have a special guest who it was surprising to see you today.
He didn't know I was coming.
I didn't know you were coming. I was at, I had one line at Love for the third season. I said one thing. I waited 9 hours to say one fucking thing while everyone got to see a million things. And I drove down here, and this is what happened to me. So I go to the Shake Shack, because you said you were with Jenna, right, Khalyla?
Mm-hmm.
And next to the Shake Shack on Hollywood, there's a shake place, health drink place. A juicery kind of a thing. So I go in there, I got like a blueberry beverage, and this Korean dude goes, "Hey, are you Bobby Lee?" I go, yeah. He goes, "Oh, I live in Korea."
He spoke like that?
No.
Okay, I was about to say.
Nope.
Not at all.
Nope. I go, "Cool." He goes, "You know Danny Cho?" I go, "Yeah, I love Danny Cho, right?" And I just start talking to him. I go, "You know what? I'm going to buy you a shake."
You told that to him?
Yeah, so I got him a blueberry shake.
It was you chose the blueberry or he did?
I chose it.
That's weird.
He goes, "I eat it too." So then when we walked out of the place, he goes, "There's a new sushi place right there. You want sushi?" And I go, "Are you going to pay?" "I'll pay." So I had sushi with a stranger.
That's very unlike you.
I swear to God on my parents' life. I have a photo of, actually, I knew you were going to say that. So I actually have a photo of him eating with him.
I still don't believe it.
That's it.
I think this is a falsehood.
I'm going to go to the, I'm going to go to the.
Where are you going?
I'll be right back.
He's going to get the picture. He's going to get the picture.
He's going to go get the picture.
Bobby just
You took a picture of it on your phone, so you reverse fanned him?
He never does that, right? Because like people, one, if you're, I feel like that's dangerous, right? As a celebrity to just have lunch with a stranger.
No, I mean,
I don't think he's lying. Yeah. I think he's telling the truth.
He is telling the truth. Yeah. Look at this. I can look at his smile.
I'll tell you why.
I think you're telling the truth.
I hate being challenged like that by her. So I said that he knew Danny Cho, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I, when I was eating with this fucking guy, right? I go, do you know this guy? He goes, yep. We are eating together and I just met him. He goes, yeah, Aaron is a good dude. And that's him.
Oh.
All right.
Can I take a look, Bob?
Yeah. So he goes, and I sat there and ate with this Korean dude. And
was
and
he alone too?
He was alone too.
You see him again?
And I go, you're not going to slip any, I said to him, nice. You're not going to slip any drugs into these sushis and then like fuck me in the ass at, in the W because that's where he's staying.
Yeah.
He goes, no, I'm not going to do that. So, but I've never done that before. I've never, a stranger.
That's nice.
Eating a meal with
somebody.
What do you think
the difference was this time? Why you were inclined to?
Why were you open to break bread with a stranger?
Yeah, because you're normally not like that.
I'm never. I told him that
usually
too. I looked at him. I go,
you know,
hey, hey, Ching Chong. I go, Ching Chong. I never do this. Mm-hmm. He goes, I don't do it either.
Sounds like a love story.
Yeah. Is he?
I don't do this either.
Did he have an accent?
No.
He didn't talk like that.
And then I'll show you this too. Anyway.
See well, I think
Steve,
that
have you done that before, Steve? Like a stranger is like, oh, I know you from Mangchi. Can we eat some sushi?
No, also, is that how you say it, Mangchi?
No, it's a white guy saying it.
Oh, okay, yeah.
No, it's usually like a teenage person.
Yeah, that's the
on
meal
on the street.
Mm.
Oh wow,
yeah, it's really good sushi.
Sugarfish?
No, it's just a place. It's like a new place, but it looked good inside, so I ate there. Pretty good. Anyway, I want to take you there, babe.
Same thing.
Anyway, so then I met this guy. So then it rolled up. I'm like, you know, I don't feel a little sick right now.
Yeah.
And I was like, I don't know if I want to do a podcast. And I see Steebee Weeby in my living room.
Yeah, you know, I had to stop by, you know.
Yeah, my little brother, Steebee Weeby.
Yeah.
Yo, dude, so I saw your podcast, dude.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What'd you think? It's been hard work, huh, Bryce?
Absolutely.
George?
Yeah, I love it.
These guys are the best. They've been coming every week.
And the most annoying
part
of it.
It's been hard work.
Most annoying part of it, babe?
Why do you want me to say it?
Tell everyone what the most annoying part of it is.
I don't know.
It's him wearing glasses.
Oh, we're talking about the pink
one? We're talking
about
George.
This motherfucker.
You look cool, man.
No, that's not Steve. No,
dude, no, he looked cool.
So George is wearing red sunglasses.
Yeah.
The red sunglasses.
And he's laughing and cackling it up like a fucking... Oh god damn.
I love it.
I love it when he does that. Why?
Well, it's this is all new to me.
Yeah.
And I didn't realize how much work it took every week, but then it's hard to carry it on your own.
Yeah.
Like you guys could like work off each other.
But Steve, what you're doing is also a lot. I mean, you're putting on puppet shows,
puppet
and
Roger.
Singing, and you're doing,
I'm doing
the whole
piano. I'm doing
you're
the
doing
background
a
artwork.
Whole one man vaudeville show.
So it's been hard work, but what do you think, Bryce? You think it'll pay off?
Bryce is like,
no, I respect Bryce's.
Why do you respect him?
Well, dude, he's editing every week.
Yeah, but
he's doing
why
music
the
videos.
Respect,
yeah, I appreciate him.
So
that's
different.
Why every week I try to get you a ginger beer and
what a nice guy you
coconut
are.
Coconut water.
You get ginger beer?
Yeah.
Bryce?
Yeah, get him snacks.
Is Steve a better host than us, Bryce?
Steve is pretty dope.
Oh,
yeah,
damn.
My brother's dope.
Pretty
you
nice.
Know,
yeah.
You sweetie.
It's been tough, but you know, I got to give Dave and DVDSA the credit. Like, you know.
But you can also take some credit for yourself because it's hard fucking work. Steve.
It is. It's been hard.
Yeah.
So where did we find
your
YouTube?
Shout out to the 600 subscribers.
Wow.
How many do we have? How many do we have, George?
Yeah.
Like 650?
And let me say something, too.
Yeah.
I want to ask you a question. I'm never going to blurt out personal shit about you.
Yeah.
Because I know so much.
Oh, I know.
Right?
Look
at me right now.
You can't even look
Steve,
at me.
Look at me right now. I know some things. I know some things about you, right, that are pretty disturbing.
Yeah. I mean,
Every time I see you, you go, don't talk about my stuff on your podcast, right?
I
would never do it.
Yeah.
I would never do it.
Yeah.
But why can't I?
I don't want to go to jail.
Wait. Okay.
That stuff.
I don't want to go to jail.
Yeah, you're not gonna go to jail.
I don't want
to.
I don't think that anything you've done warrants
jail
anyhow.
Yeah.
I think that's a little. But are we allowed to talk about what your brother has forced you to do? No,
yeah, that's
no.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. Yeah, that's yeah.
Oh, see, yeah. You're worried like, about that.
Me?
Yeah.
I'm not worried about it.
Well, I had Laban. I had Laban over.
Can you reveal that then?
Okay. Well, because Laban, it's already going to be out there. Because
it's already going
to
go out there.
Yeah. Well, yeah. We didn't specify, but so when's the last time you spoke to Laban?
10 years.
Who is Laban?
There's a guy named Laban Fides. Let me do it.
He's a pro skater.
He skated for Dogtown, and Laban was the first guy to when I was using drugs to give me an intervention. He's a really good dude.
Yeah,
I love that guy.
Okay? Yeah, he's a great guy. Guy. Yeah, I hadn't seen him in like 15
Laban
years.
Has a photograph.
Wait, hold up. Are you going right there?
Is there more to the story? Oh, you want to build it?
Yeah, so.
Build it out.
Why are we talking about it?
He's a host now.
Yeah.
Well, Laban's the first guy. He picked me up from the airport.
When you first came to L.A.?
When I first came to L.A., during the dumpster days.
No, but remember the first time you visited me and I didn't pick you up? Nobody picked you up?
Oh, can we talk about that?
Well, nothing happened.
He left you stranded at the airport?
I was stranded at the airport.
And where was I?
I don't know.
I was in Vegas.
That's when you live with Shema.
Yeah.
And he had like fucking 10 cats. I almost died. Like my immune system broke down. Yeah.
Oh, because you were allergic before.
Yeah.
Well, Shema had a bunch of cats. I hated them. So anyway, back to the photo.
Yeah. So anyway. Laban was there when I first moved to LA when we lived on, in Silver Lake, Echo Park area. And man, he was your best friend.
Yeah. I love him.
But he did something.
What'd he do?
Get to the point.
What do you and I do?
I don't know. I think one night I stuck a. It had to do with your butthole in a Snickers bar.
What?
What?
Okay, get directly into.
Well, I was gonna stick.
What it is this?
I was gonna stick.
I was gonna stick a Snickers bar
in your butthole.
You took a Snickers bar. And you stuck it in my asshole.
Well, you willingly, because you wanted him to?
I don't know. We didn't.
Wow, guys.
Thing is, I didn't know.
What did you know?
Laban was there, and when he took the picture, my face was.
So you were inserting it like by his butthole?
Yeah, and Laban took a picture of it.
Yeah.
So I'm like this. And he, Bob had a big birthday party at the Spaghetti Factory.
I used to have. Okay, so mine was that. There used to be a spaghetti factory on Sunset Boulevard, and I used to do my birthday parties there, and they used to be the best. Now, I'm not kidding you. I mean, Mencia, Pauly Shore, Mad TV people, and then also comics and skaters, and it was a dinner, and so my brother and I are sitting there at this, about 60, 70 people there. And Laban,
I mean, dude, your management was there.
Yeah, Abby was there. Yeah,
Abby
Matt
was
Blake,
there. Everyone was there.
Yeah, my agent, everything.
And so what Laban did, he made multiple copies, Xerox copies of my face, with the Snickers bar in his butthole, and then you could see Bob's nutsack, and I was like this.
He's sticking it in his butthole.
And he passed it around.
No, it's not. It was basically everyone that came to the party got one.
Oh, like a gift. It was a gift.
Like, welcome to the party,
Yeah.
Which I didn't.
It's like a grab bag.
Yeah, but
Bobby Lee grab.
And then what?
Well, it ruined. I don't know if you remember. I was close to dating someone named Rose.
Yeah.
And that. And she afterwards, she came up to me.
And what'd she say?
Why did you do it?
Why did she look at you like you killed a person?
Yeah.
Why did you do it, Steve? Why? And then she was like shaking.
Oh my God! So Laban fucked you.
What did I do? Stop!
Steve,
you did put it in his butt.
But it was my face.
You could have said no.
Number one, this is what you. Let me ask you something. Let's go back. Let's go back in time. Let's go back to Steve.
Yeah.
Just pretend you're you. This is 15 years ago. Steve.
Yeah.
See that Snickers bar?
Yeah.
Can you stick it in my ass?
I think it was more like a dare. I double dog dare you. Type
yeah,
thing.
I dared you at first. You said no.
I triple dog dare you. I'm like, fuck.
Yeah, and they did it.
You know
it's
what?
Me, Laban. Gotcha, bitch.
Now that I think about it, You're right. It affected me, solely me, because your face, it could have been anyone's butthole and nutsack.
Yes, that's what it was.
But it was my face.
Because at that time, you know, so that, it you was know that my star, face. That thing on my butt? Yeah. It wasn't there at the time.
You didn't have a tattoo of the star.
I didn't have a tattoo on my butt.
Anyone's butt. Anyone's
so
butt.
It could have been, you know, my cousin's butt.
Yeah.
Or any, it could have been any Asian guy's butt.
But it was for sure a guy because of the nutsack.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was his nuts, and then it was my face.
Yeah, your face was
there. I had a shaved head back then. So.
Yeah.
Okay. And then,
so Rose didn't want to fuck you after that.
Oh yeah, that killed.
Would you? Do you care about it now? Like if I went to Ilani, your girlfriend, can I say they have a girlfriend?
You didn't have to say her name though. Like can we blurt that? Yeah.
Why?
Well, I didn't want to put her.
Because people are gonna. Like,
yeah, they're gonna like. You know how people are. They're gonna be researching and.
That's what I don't like about you right now, man.
What do you mean? What do you mean?
I didn't say anything bad. I just said your girlfriend's name, and
I'm
that's
just not trying
weird.
To put her on blast.
I know.
Like
it's not putting her on blast. Okay. So listen, you're not beeping it.
All right, just put it
look,
on there.
No, look at, no, you're not beeping it.
Yeah, okay.
Because I didn't say anything bad, okay?
Yeah. No, that's fine.
All right.
Yeah.
So if I showed her the photo, would you be embarrassed now?
She'd probably laugh.
She'd laugh.
That's what I'm saying, you're growing.
She'd probably laugh.
Yeah, you can bleep it out if you want.
No, you don't have to bleep it out.
Well, now we go. Here we go, we're growing.
Yeah. I'm sorry for that. Yeah. I didn't really. What do you think about it? You think that's bad?
I think you should just post it now.
Yeah.
Really?
It's just a Snickers thing. Bar it's and an anus.
You might even get a sponsorship from Snickers.
Yeah.
Well, Pringles likes
Pringles and Snickers,
Pringles
guys.
Guys.
How do you know they like us?
Well, I don't know. Are you making a T-shirt, a Pringles T-shirt?
Yeah, but that doesn't mean that it's not endorsed by Pringles.
I don't know.
Yeah,
well, you thought Pringles called us?
Yeah, we heard you made. I heard the story or something, man.
Yeah. But in general, you get embarrassed by, and also just by the vibe.
I'm not gonna say anything.
Steve, just look at me. You're getting weird right now.
Okay,
look at me right now, dude.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna put you on blast, bro.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna say the things that you've done together. You know what I mean?
Most of the stories that I've heard are always Steve being innocent and you forcing him into situations. Like I feel like he fucked you up. Like he traumatized you.
Was I a bad brother?
No, you're good. I had I had some weird.
What'd you do to my friends growing up?
Oh, you're talking about Craig?
And Megan.
I was kind of a...
What'd you do?
I have had some asshole situations.
What did you do, Steve?
I'll just say it. My brother is senior in high school, or like junior in high school.
I was cutting weight, though. You have to consider I was cutting weight. I was cutting weight for
and
wrestling.
And my friend Craig, who's the nicest kid.
Yeah.
Not a violent, just a regular white kid, right? They're playing basketball outside, and then all of a sudden I hear my brother just go, "What the fuck?"
Yeah,
I'm pushing Craig.
Hey,
go, bitch, what are you gonna do something?
You know what I mean?
And I'm like, dude, what are you doing?
Yeah, I know.
And then my friend Megan came over.
And I pushed you in front of her.
No, you go, what are you looking at, bitch, or something like that.
No, I didn't.
Yeah. And I was just like, and then I pulled you aside and I go, don't talk to my friends that way, dude.
Oh, I didn't mean to do that. I'm so sorry.
But you were cutting weight.
Yeah, I was cutting.
People get loony.
Like that.
Well,
low electrolytes causes confusion.
Yeah, I'm so sorry. I don't remember doing that. I'm so sorry. I feel bad now.
So what?
Why?
That was 35 years ago.
I think it's still pinned up in me.
Really?
Yeah. Because if I look back and look at Megan Hewitt, and Craig Crawford.
They're good people.
They're good.
Yeah.
Really. I mean, I used to have friends.
Was it my sophomore year or junior?
No, you were a junior or maybe even the senior or whatever.
No, that's not true because that was in high school, right? So I was freshman.
All right.
I was a freshman or sophomore. Freshman.
You're forgiven.
Not by me.
Sorry, man.
It's okay.
I mean, if they're here today, I would definitely say, you know, I'd say sorry for doing that.
Guys, come on out right now.
Yeah.
They're out here. Craig and Megan, I'm sorry.
So, Khalyla,
Can
we talk about it? Can we talk about, so Khalyla the other day, I'm laying in bed, she goes, go watch this video, and I saw this video, and it disturbed the fuck out of me.
Yeah.
And I want to show it to you. You have it saved, babe?
You have to describe what it is to
I have it in my head, I have questions in my head.
Okay.
And I want you guys to go to this journey with me.
Okay, so go to, if you're on Instagram, go to the user taco.song.
His videos are disturbing, by the way.
Wait, oh my god, oh, he deleted it.
Dang, he did.
I think so.
Oh, it was on Instagram.
What is it? Describe it.
I think he did.
Well, let me go back. Let me go.
Yeah, but
no. Hold on, let me do it. Taco.song. All right, so we found the video. Thank you, George, for finding the video.
Thank you,
so Khalyla shows me this video of this. I don't know where. I think he looks Iraqi or Persian, right? He's a kid, right?
So looks like he's somewhere in a desert.
Somewhere in the desert, right? And let me bring the light up. Is there any way to put it? Oh, it doesn't matter. I think you can see it, right?
You can see it.
So you can see it?
Yeah.
So watch.
Can you play close to the mic?
All right, so there's no audio.
Oh, wow.
So there's a donkey. There's a kid right there, right? Look.
Uh-oh.
He's fucking a donkey. He zips it up, his pants up, right? Right? He smiles.
Whoa.
Oh. Right? And then
his friends are laughing.
His
at
friends
him.
Are laughing, if you can hear it, right? Mm-hmm. And yeah, that's the video. That's pretty much the video.
He was like reverse donkey style.
No, yeah, so let me tell
he
you.
He was
something.
Like going
number
deep.
Number one is this, okay? If you're gonna fuck a donkey,
okay, listen up, guys. Listen up.
Just hear me out.
Listen up to Bobby right now.
If you're gonna fuck a donkey, listen. Look, everybody. Can you wait 5 hours until it's night? Do you have to do it at noon during lunchtime? Okay.
That is the brightest.
Number
part
two.
Of the
can
day.
I just say this? Here's another one.
That's crazy.
Do you have to fuck the donkey in front of his friends?
In front of his donkey friends.
He's raping a donkey in front of his. Donkey friends.
Oh my God. I've never seen anything.
Right,
like
right.
That.
Look at. Okay.
Oh my
right.
God.
The next thing. I think about this. Right. Look at. How is the kid positioned, Steve? When you see it.
He's actually sitting
on his
down.
It's like when a girl does reverse cowgirl.
Right.
But it's like reverse donkey.
He's doing this.
Yeah, he's sitting down and he's doing that.
Yeah.
That's
you're
he's
fucking
thrusting
a donko,
his hips
if,
upward.
If you're gonna fuck a donkey, do it standing. You know why? You're gonna make the donkey do the work. You're
animal.
Gonna rape a donkey, but then you're like, you do the work.
Yeah, the donkey's on top.
Oh my God.
Okay.
How old is that kid?
I don't know.
He's probably like 14.
Oh
looks
my
like.
God.
Here's the last thing
Let
I want to say.
Let me see it one more time.
Yeah. Here's a, okay. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, don't say it that way.
Yes.
Don't say it so.
Yeah, don't
seductive.
Say it like that.
Let me see it one more time.
Oh, don't do it like that. No.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Did you say that again?
Hold up.
Rewind.
Yeah, yeah.
Let me see it one more time.
There we go. There we go. Yeah. Like a professor.
That was worse.
Yeah,
that was weirder.
Give me another shot.
Yeah, give me another shot. Go.
Let me see it one more time.
Oh.
Whoa.
That's scientific.
That was like.
How did I say it the first
very
time?
Very commanding.
Let me see it one more time.
Let me see it one more time, Bob.
Yeah, yeah.
Bob,
with a little
please.
Bit of salivation. It was not
yeah,
good.
I don't know why saliva was dripping down your chin.
Right. So here's the thing. Yeah. Let me just say something, okay? So watch it. Donkey friends.
Poor donkey
do it during
friends.
The day, right? Don't let the donkey do all the work. And then see, stop right here. I want to show you this.
Oh, you went to look.
Let me ask you, Steve. Let me ask you something. Steve, let me ask you something right now. Okay, let me ask you something. If you're gonna, if you fucked a donkey during
yeah.
the day like that, just hear me out, right? And Gilbert came around the corner with a video camera. Let me ask you something. Would you smile?
No.
Steve, what would you do?
I would say, dude, please.
Steve, ready? Ready? Steve?
yeah.
I'll
no.
Go.
Fuck the donkey.
No.
Fuck the donkey. Ready?
No. 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 That's not what would happen.
Ready?
What?
If you don't give me the camera right now,
oh, it'd
you're
be
gonna fucking die.
You're right. It'd be a quick double.
Right.
It would just.
You
be
don't
like,
smile. Look
like
at look at how long
leg.
He takes.
He's embarrassed.
Look at how long he takes.
Yeah. Oh no, that camera would be broken.
Yeah.
That camera would be broken.
Grab the camera.
You grab the camera. Right?
But also, like, I feel like his friends are fucked up if they posted it. Like that kid could get into some serious legal trouble. They could stone
PETA.
Him to death.
PETA.
Not by PETA, just because you live in like.
I think they're in another country.
Yeah, it's a different country. Yeah.
Okay.
And also, is it your donkey? That's another thing.
Oh, then you're the owner.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm the owner. I'm...
Dude, if it's... Okay, how about this? If it's my donkey you're fucking, then I'm allowed to tape you.
Right.
What?
No, why is everything you're saying so sexual?
Sexy, right.
No,
that's, yeah.
You were really sad about this after watching the video.
I was really disturbed by it. I thought about it all night.
What country did this like, take place in?
I don't know.
What's your guess?
Somewhere in the Middle East.
Yeah,
but I feel like this happens a lot in any, you know, provincial area. Because I know that I have cousins who've like fucked sheep or like fucked goats and stuff.
Oh.
Yeah, I mean, it's just one of those things that weird kids do because they're not. No one will fuck them, and they're curious, and there's a hole.
Dude, masturbate, beat off.
I know.
See, that's right there. That's why you're smart.
So I have a question for you guys.
Yeah.
What's the weirdest
aside
thing
from a Pringles can, what is the weirdest thing you've inserted your penis into?
Oh,
ooh, that's a good
that's
one.
Good one.
Real good one.
I meat.
Weirdest.
Meat.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ, that's even worse. A dead animal versus a live animal.
No, I just go to the Vons.
I know, but that's a dead animal. Like, that's...
I tried it.
Well, what kind of meat first? Dead. Ground? It's, ground meat?
No, not ground meat.
Why
no,
are
no.
my... Why
yeah,
are
why
you pulling,
touching me like that? Like, deli meat? I took a steak. Yeah. And I just drilled a hole in it, right? And I tried to squeeze... And then I stuck it on my penis, and yeah. I tried to squeeze it together, right? To give it friction, right? And it kind of bent like this, yeah. And it just ripped apart.
Damn, you have a strong Jesus. Dick.
Okay. I don't know if this counts, but in, when we lived in Power, we had a jacuzzi.
Yeah. Fuck the jet.
Yeah. Yeah. So I would when it got hot in there, I would stick. I would stick.
I think a lot of people do that.
It felt so good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You ever do that, George?
You get worried when other people are going in there after you.
Yeah.
Like, no. I mean,
you're
no.
like.
You know what I do on the road?
Oh, you put the massage.
Yeah. Okay. What else? You mind, babe?
We've already talked about this. The little Brookstone thing.
Yeah.
The vibration.
Yeah.
You basically.
But okay, here's the thing, and this is my, it's been a problem over the years, and I'm gonna reveal something about myself, that I'm not gonna say anything to anybody. I don't know why you're scared right now.
I got one.
I know, but I know you're scared right now. But can I just reveal something about myself?
Yeah.
So I eat Unisom.
Yeah.
And what the Unisom does, it makes me horny.
Mm-hmm. We've right. talked about this.
Right. And then what I do is I will... Why are you looking at me like that?
Oh, no. I just zoned out.
Why?
I don't know. I was daydreaming. I was like...
Are you listening to what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
He's thinking about what I said. He's thinking about the donkey. Okay.
No, I'm not. I'll repeat. You take Unisom. Mm-hmm. And when you take the Unisom, it gets you horny.
For some reason,
For
does.
Some reason. Mm-hmm. Okay, so I'm listening.
Have you ever taken Unisom?
Yeah.
Does it get you horny?
Yes. Absolutely.
I know that about you.
Yeah. Yeah,
because you guys you are and the I've same DNA.
We have the same DNA, yeah. Right? And you take the massager, right? And you just gently don't push it on there, right? And you watch porn, and it, you know, I've done that.
Just on the head?
Yeah.
Not on the shaft at all?
Sometimes on the shaft.
Yeah.
And if you hit it right,
mm-hmm.
it's like.
But you know, there is such a thing that women have to be careful with getting we have to be careful with vibrator desensitized by a vibrator. So it's actually not good for us to always use a vibrator, because a dick can never compare afterwards, and we can't orgasm from coitus alone when if we're so used to the strong vibrations of a vibrator.
Or on your clitoris?
Yeah. Because nothing compares. It's the best feeling in the world.
I don't know why. This is a lowbrow episode.
A very lowbrow.
What's lowbrow? So, what is lowbrow?
It's just
sex
and
poop and dick
donkey
and
fucking.
Like
donkey
a lot like fucking. Like today I was like today I was on Love, and mm-hmm. one of the producers goes, "I heard you on the Doughboys, which is a great podcast, right?" Mm-hmm. Then I go, "Do you listen to mine?" He goes, "Nope." And because it's lowbrow.
Did he say that?
I think we talk about some cool things sometimes.
No, I mean, I feel like, why do I have to talk about stuff like that?
It's sprinkled in there, but you guys have some
I think
deep
that
conversations.
Your history and your life has been has a very, very deep sexual past. A lot of your stories has to do with a lot of sexual repression, can't get the pussy.
So
a lot of it, you know, stems from.
But there's more to life. There's like, you know, spirituality, helping others.
Okay.
There's, you know, we could talk about sports, movies, mm-hmm. art,
oh, we went
film.
To look for a dog last week, me and Alani.
What happened?
You're getting a dog?
Yeah.
What happened?
Well, we went to two places. Can I talk about this?
Yeah.
We went to the Pasadena Humane Society, which is awesome.
Was where we got our cat Gooner.
Yeah, very mm-hmm. good facility. The volunteers are great. The staff are very helpful. Mm-hmm. Then we did the opposite. We went to San Gabriel Valley Humane Society, which was so bad.
Yeah.
Like, why?
Well, firstly, I walk in there. There was, like, barely anyone in there. Like, usually there's no one in the office. And when I walked outside, it was just like this vibe was. Remember when we gave Dolly up?
Yeah.
It was that vibe. Ooh, you know, crying.
Yeah.
And there was this collective fear, you know what I'm saying? Like, it reminded me like a jail for them, like a like the San Quentin of dogs.
I have a question for you guys.
Dogs, yeah.
Wow.
I have a question. So most of the residents of San Gabriel Valley are what?
Chinese,
Asian.
Oh, yeah. Chinese.
Do you think that has anything to do with the quality of that?
I think you're kind of maybe reaching. I don't know.
No, because I'll tell you. What you're saying right now is this.
Yeah. I'm not talking about eating dogs. I'm not talking about that.
That the dogs in this humane society know they can smell the Chinese.
No, 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 no. That's not what I'm saying.
And they're like,
You're gonna come get us. After thinking about it, I know why I'm wrong. Because the Downy SPCA
is not as good either.
And there's like no Asians there, so I'm wrong.
So anyway, we are and then so
the dogs can smell the Chinese. Sorry,
that's not what I
said. That's interesting though.
Yeah.
But I was looking at.
It was so inquisitive too. Huh.
Yeah.
I was looking at one particular one. It looked like a Maltese mix. And but it was there's so much barking, like every chihuahua was like, you know, they were going crazy. Yeah. Like, don't even get near me. And so I was just kind of like covering my ears because it was so loud.
Mm-hmm.
And this white lady with gray hair walked by and she was like, can you please not like mess with the dogs or don't tease the dogs? OK. Mm-hmm. And then walk by.
Jesus.
And so, my eyes crossed
my eyes.
The rage.
The rage.
Yeah. And then I looked at. Alani and I go, but then I paused.
Yeah,
and I didn't. I didn't say anything.
That's called growth.
Yeah, I didn't say anything to her.
My brother and I didn't grow up with, and we tried to do animals, but we would keep them for 3 days, and then we had a dog, Buddha.
Yeah, it was a Rottweiler.
And then one day we just saw it get in the pool man's truck, and they just drove away.
They stole your dog.
No, my mom just said to him, "Take it."
That sounds like an Asian thing.
Because when you're young, you don't know about the responsibilities of what it takes to take care of an animal.
Yeah.
You kind of like just bypass that. You're like, oh.
And then we never really grew up with them. Yeah. And I think the reason why I love Khalyla, and there's many reasons.
She loves
animals. A thousand reasons.
She loves animals.
Thousands. One of the main, a lot of the main reasons is because she made me love, other beings.
Yeah.
And other living things.
He's gotten better, right? You know,
he has. No, he's obsessed with his animals now. So that's why it's hard for me to hear stories. It's unbelievable for me to think that he would ever intentionally try to like run over like a possum.
Yeah.
You know.
You were about to say something.
Well, I didn't want to bring up Dolly, but we don't have to talk.
Have
about
we talked her. About Dolly on this podcast?
Haven't talked about poor Dolly.
We've danced around it.
Just tell the real story of Dolly.
I mean, do you mind?
Okay. It was probably one
of the worst days of my life.
And it's one of the, in retrospect, is one of my worst days.
No, honestly.
He has a lot of regrets.
Shut the fuck up.
Okay.
Shut the fuck up. All right. Listen to me right now. Okay. All right.
All
right. The other day in the car, what the fuck did I say to you?
You said, dude, I'm so sorry about Dolly.
No cameras, nothing, right?
Yeah.
I looked at you like a fucking brother, right?
You said it several times.
Exactly. Tears in my eyes,
like,
right?
In his Prius, and he's like, dude, I'm so sorry about Dolly.
Yeah.
I'm so, you know. I knew it was genuine, and you know.
All right,
you meant it.
I didn't mean it.
I'm not, just to let you know and the viewers know, I have no, I'm not resentful towards it. I've grown past it.
Yeah.
And that's why I'm ready to get another dog, because I'm ready, you know what I mean, to go on.
And just before you tell the story, too, I want to say this.
Yeah.
This is before I met Khalyla.
Yeah, was that?
Way before, and then also on top of it, I fucking hated your dog.
Yeah, I know.
He was a piece of shit.
It was a she.
Oh, yeah.
But it's okay.
My bad.
Yeah.
Okay.
And you know what?
But in retrospect, what I did was absolutely wrong.
Yeah, no, it's fine.
No, tell the story.
Okay, so I...
You know what? I'm so freaked out right now. I need a dip. Can I dip once, babe?
I'm
going to spit in here.
I have some grizzly.
Yeah.
In the coconut water.
So my mom calls me up at 4 or 5 in the morning.
Who, your mom?
Mom. Because that's when we thought dad was dying.
Before even that, how you got Dolly in the first place.
Okay, so I had a neighbor. He was a 93-year-old man, Colin Drake.
That's a video game character.
Yeah.
He was an interesting man. He comes from old Hollywood, you know. He was a theatrical guy, like an actor, like old school.
Yeah.
93-year-old man.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I used to walk Dolly because he couldn't walk. He would fall over. Mm-hmm. I mean, one time, it's when I worked for the Israeli locksmith guy, Shlomi.
Mm-hmm.
And I went over for 30.
These are real names.
Yeah, Shlomi. That's amazing. Shlomi Strasberg. Yeah.
Shlomi.
And I went over there, and I remember walk Dolly, and he was on the ground, and he was like, Steve, like, help me. Like, he was like, always falling over. He was old. And so I remember another time I went over to walk Dolly, and there was firemen inside his apartment, and Dolly was running in circles, trying to bite their ankles.
Yeah. Aww.
So that was her move. So she and his place smelled awful. Like, it was this old carpet, just years of urination.
Aww.
And poo.
What kind of Hollywood old? Come on.
He was, yeah.
He was 93.
He was 93.
Yeah, but in the 20s, he did gay videos. I mean, what kind of actor was he?
He did.
What movies was he
Pay in? Your respects,
no,
Bobby.
He
was an older guy.
He did a couple commercials. He had some ad campaigns like you. Probably not as big as what you've done. But he had some ad campaigns.
You know what, mister? That was an attack.
No, that wasn't
an attack. Yeah, mister, that was an attack on me. And you just, your tone was wrong.
He had a couple of ad campaigns.
Ask me again. Ask me again.
What? Yeah, so you say he's from old Hollywood, right?
Yes.
So what do you think he's done?
He's been overseas. And he's done plays overseas.
Oh, theater. He's a thespian. He's a thespian.
Exactly.
He was a street performer in Bangkok.
Yeah. No.
He's a robot.
He's been in legit stuff.
He was on an electric guitar and like, what do you call it, tricycle.
Look at him. No. See, he has on Wikipedia.
Wait, are you looking up Colin?
Yeah, he's on Wikipedia. He has his Wikipedia.
That's Colin Drake. That's him.
Oh, my God. He arrived.
Wait, read it. Read it, George. Read it. Read it, George.
Here, pass it to me, George.
Pass it to Khalyla. That was my
My bad, Colin. You're dead, and I apologize. I disrespected you.
Read it.
You have Wikipedia. Oh, fuck.
Colin Drake.
Yeah, read his stats.
It's good to haunt us now.
Good job, dude. Good job for finding that.
Born March 8th, 1917 in England, United Kingdom.
He's English?
Died March 27th, 2011 in Auburn, California. He's in movies, OSS 117, Terror in Tokyo, The Great McCarthy, Barney, and... Honigsmark.
Terror in Tokyo.
That's amazing. Can I see the photo?
Yeah, that's
look at all the movies he's done.
Yeah. Can I just say this, though? It's not the same Colin Drake.
Yeah, it is.
The face?
Yeah, that's Colin. But yeah. I knew him when he was 90.
His timeline is correct because
he
would have been 93.
Auburn? What's that all about?
Yeah, the timeline's correct?
Yes, it's correct.
Okay, you're right.
Yeah.
Oh, man, I was wrong.
Rest in peace, Colin.
I disrespected your IMDb.
Colin Drake.
He didn't do porn. He was a real guy.
Yeah.
I apologize.
That's where you got Dolly from.
Yeah, so I got Dolly, but this is the thing with Dolly. She was very temperamental, and Dolly was only Colin died. Yeah.
So Colin died and his daughter.
His daughter called me up and was like, do you want to take Dolly? Because if you don't, we're going to euthanize her. So I'm like, I'll take Dolly. It was like a weird day because when he like it was an empty apartment and I got her bowl and her food and I had to like tell her to come to my place and she was reluctant.
Aww.
But she
don't tell the story like this.
What?
Because it makes Bobby. Cause
I know the end of the movie.
And it makes
in the
ended
movie, the villain
is you,
is me, and I know, but it's me.
You.
I know, I understand
but
that.
I forgave
but
you.
It's still like I know that I'm the villain. So it, the way you're doing it, I don't like it.
Okay, but anyway,
so
okay.
Lighten it up. It's a PG movie. All right, lighten it up.
All right, it's not Logan.
Dolly was only used to being with one owner, and anyone who got near that one owner would lose her mind and like protect that person.
Yeah.
You know, with her life. So when I think it was the week I got her, you're like, hey, let me meet your dog.
Yeah.
When I lived in the smaller studio.
Yeah.
And I remember when Bob came in, she lost her mind. You know, like just
crazy.
And then he would like, I've never seen you in fear of like an animal like that.
Well, it latched on.
Yeah, try to bite
your
ankles.
No, it latched onto my ankle and I was dragging it on the ground for a bit.
Yeah.
Like it hurt so bad.
Yeah.
So like my Achilles heel.
Yeah.
Sorry. I didn't know. I mean,
it's
I was
fine. You're a good dude. You're
I didn't
a good
know.
Dude.
I had to learn as I went.
Yeah.
So I didn't know, you know.
And
so
then
that
you
was
also,
Dolly.
But can I just say this? You locked it in your bathroom a couple times.
Well, when I
you would
when
leave.
I left like out. Like,
you
yeah,
treated it like a crate.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Like, oh, that was a crate.
Yeah, it was my crate.
That's okay.
Yeah,
fine.
Yeah.
All right.
So anyway, sorry, man. I mean, sorry. I wish I had better act. You know.
No, that's how you do it.
Yeah.
Anyway, my bad.
So
then what happened?
Well, we got a call from my mom like 5 a.m. or something like that.
Can I take over the story?
Yeah, go ahead.
May I?
Yeah, go ahead.
So my mom calls and goes, Bobby, daddy, he not going to make it.
It's time. Yeah.
It's time. Mm-hmm. And when your parent mom says it's time, I've never, you become a tunnel, right? And your adrenaline goes, and it's like your focus is on just this is a moment, right? That's never going to happen again.
Yeah.
And it's terrible. And
it's probably one of the worst days of my life.
Yeah. I call my brother. He was up, right?
Yeah, it was really.
And I go, we got to drive to Phoenix right now. We can get there in 4.5 hours.
Yeah.
And my brother goes, what are we going to do with Dolly? I go, there's a hotel. Remember I said that first?
Yeah, you probably said something.
What?
Well, yeah, you did say that.
Then. I think I did.
Yeah, I don't remember.
I don't really either.
Okay.
I don't remember either. Mm-hmm. But I went, I go, we can't take, imagine this, okay? My parents never, they're not animal lovers. Mm-hmm. They don't know anything about animals, especially this animal. I mean, I'm sure Dolly's a sweet dog, but anything but Steve, it just would go crazy.
Yeah,
and bite ankles. So in my head, I'm like, what? The dog is going to be in my parents' house? You know what I mean? If my dad dies and then I have this dog running around barking at everybody, you know what I mean? While we're mourning, mm-hmm. right? So I'm like, well, let's figure out where to drop it off. It's early in the morning, too.
So I didn't know. I mean, people in hindsight, like after the fact, were like, dude, I would have taken care of it. It's like, dude, it's like 4 or 5 in the morning.
Yeah.
I'm not going to like put you through, you know what
it
I mean?
It was an emergency situation.
Yeah. Exactly. So I said, we're just going to have to bring it to the Humane Society.
Yeah, it was on the one on Lacey Street.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
and we rolled up. And my brother is like, you have to bring it in.
Well, can I take over? can I add some stuff?
A lot of baton handles here.
Yeah.
wait, can I just say this? Go forth gently, my friend.
Oh, okay.
Pass it to Khalyla.
So I remember it was an empty parking lot. There was only a few other cars. It was like right when they're opening or something at this point. So right when, Dolly knew right away because I opened the door and then I heard that collective.
All right.
You know, like the crying, and then I was holding under her, and she was.
I feel so fucking bad.
She was like shaking, and so we roll up to the reception area, and you could take over. You could take it over.
It peed.
She peed out of fright.
Yeah. Out of fear.
Yeah, she urinated.
It was shaking.
Yeah.
Immensely. Okay.
Yeah, she urinated in the.
Yeah, and she urinated all over the lobby. Of this place.
Mm-hmm.
Why are you looking at me like that?
I'm not. I've heard this story so many times, and it gets sadder and sadder each time.
Yeah.
I don't and even so know why you should. Okay, but okay.
About what? About
this
why I did this?
A sad story.
Yeah. I was left with in an emergency.
Yeah.
Hey, bitch. I think my dad's dying.
I know, but my thing is, why did you insist on euthanizing versus just giving up the dog?
No. That's what they said.
Yeah, we didn't know what kind of place it was,
and what did the dog have? A cough.
She was old.
She was suffering at that time anyway.
Yeah, because she
it was
be,
an old dog. It was coughing up this phone. It was sick. It should have been.
She
euthanized.
Was very, 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 very old. I didn't. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Very,
so
very, very
I already
old.
Knew that. Yeah. Right. It was not normal. Yeah, it was just always coughing, and it had like lung disease or something.
So let's just cut it. Let's make the long story short.
No. I like the build. Okay. It peed in the lobby, right? Then, and I grabbed it. I go, I got it.
And then you put it in
And I put it in the cage. Could they go, put it in that cage.
I couldn't look at her, by the
way. Yeah, my brother's crying.
Yeah, crying.
And I said, are they going to kill this dog? And they're like, probably.
Yeah, and then then you got me a frappuccino. And then we went to Starbucks. And then you got me a frappuccino.
Don't go straight to frappuccino.
I literally heard my brother was crying. And he got me a frappuccino. And it was good. It was so much sugar, but it was good.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I didn't want to go there like emotionally.
So
I don't want to revisit that. Cause
I looked at Dolly, and I'm gonna say this right now.
I
regret.
No, it's cool.
No, shut up.
It's cool.
I regret every single one of them, and I literally have looked at him because I love
you love, but now
I love Gobi so fucking
much. So let me ask you something. Like, if that were to happen now, you'd probably react a different way.
Khalyla will take it.
Yeah.
He would be devastated. His heart would break into
him. Yeah, my heart would break.
Now, you know, you have animals
yourself. And then what happened to the drive over there? We get the...
Oh, you want to go further?
Let's go further.
Oh, my God.
So you drive to Arizona.
So we get there.
Yeah.
And we get to the, whatever, the room in the hospital. And my dad looks like a skeleton.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and okay, I'm going to say that. The last time I saw my dad before that, he was walking around.
Mm-hmm.
He looked like a human, like a the way he looks, mm-hmm. right? We see a man in the bed that looks like Auschwitz fucking.
Yeah, we
like
we,
just
we were all bawling.
You could see his legs, right? And it was all bone, right?
And we just started and crying.
His back was arched, mm-hmm. and he was going like making a noise I've never heard him do. And my brother and I literally collapsed on the ground.
Oh.
Yeah,
right. And we just that was it. And we started. I've never cried. I mean,
that was one of the worst days.
I mean, God, the worst day of my life.
But tell him further what dad's. He, my dad kept pointing. There's a bathroom to his left.
Well, now we're getting into mysticism.
No, but you.
I know, but go ahead.
So he started going.
Yeah.
And then you asked dad, like you said, hey, what is it?
Yeah.
He was pointing at something.
Like a ghost or something.
Whoa. He saw
a dude with a a suit and a hat.
I think it was his dad.
It was like some ghost with a top hat and a suit.
Yeah.
Because it moved from the bathroom to the window there.
Right.
Because he was
And then
it was
then,
it was weird. It was eerie. It was very.
And I think
eerie.
My dad was kind of going, I'm not gonna go yet.
Yeah, he was fighting. I think what happened in hindsight was he saw the sons and he wanted to fight. Because he made it.
Yeah,
because he said
it could have been. It was 50-50.
Yeah, it was 50. They say
he could have gone.
Yeah, and he saw us, and you could see his will
to stay.
Yeah,
you know. But I swear to God,
that was
the worst
rough day
of my fucking life.
That
you know,
was one of that top three for me
in life.
Like, oh, dude,
right
for sure
in life. Yeah.
It was rough.
But, yeah, that was a terrible thing,
Ooh.
Dude.
He's here still.
He's still here, you know, but...
If, you know, there's this... They have this new technology that can map your entire brain and retrace every single memory you've ever had. If you want to remember every single thing, they can map it and make you remember every single thing that's ever happened in your life. Would you want to retrace your entire life and see everything, all the memories you've forgotten?
Not really.
Yeah, I would.
Yeah.
Would
you? You'd want to relive all of it.
You might, like, uncover some, like, hurt from...
But maybe some joy, too, that I forgot about.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Yeah, when a butterfly landed on my shoulder.
Yeah.
You know, that was nice.
That was...
Have there been things in your life where,
that
like...
That was nice.
Have there been things in your life that were so traumatic that you pushed and you made yourself believe it never happened?
Of course.
Of course.
Or you're like, no, that never happened. Or it happened, but you finally convinced
yourself
it didn't.
I'm
going to
say something about myself. There's probably two things that I did that I remember, and I would never tell anybody. They're not illegal. I didn't kill anybody. It's nothing like that.
Yeah.
But it's just one of those things like, why the fuck did you do that?
Yeah.
That was dumb. You know?
I think we all have a few of those.
I have a ton.
I have a ton too.
You do?
Yeah.
Where it's like
I
cringe.
Can I
tell it.
No, I can't tell it. Yeah. I will not tell it. Yeah. I almost did. But then my mind goes, what are you doing?
Right. Yeah.
This is something you said you would die to the grave, and I'm going
to
do that.
Take it to the grave.
Take it. Take one.
I'm going to die to the grave.
Take a couple.
That's not a terminology. How do you say it?
Take it
to the grave.
Cradle to the grave. Starring Jenny.
Yeah. Do you have anything like that?
No.
You don't reveal stuff about yourself.
I'm trying to think. I've nothing I would take to the grave.
Yeah.
But I mean, there's questionable things that I've done.
Yeah. How are you lately?
I'm good.
You didn't get a pilot?
No.
Are you sad about it?
No, but I did go in for 3 gay roles in a row.
Yes. You see?
3
Showing
gay roles.
You need to milk that.
I was very interested. The last role I went in for. The last shot at a series reg because like whatever the person dropped out. And I walked in the room. I didn't know it was for a gay role because they didn't tell me the breakdown. I walked in. I see 2 gay Asian guys and then Perez Hilton sitting in the audition room. I'm like, well, this is what people see me as.
Yeah. So what? Eric Stone Street's made a killing out of playing
he
a gay character.
Kills that role.
And he's
kills
not gay.
It. You know.
He's been killing it.
Yeah. Yeah, me and Eric, my brother and I know Eric well.
Dude.
Good dude.
Good dude. Yeah.
Yeah. Remember we went to that Brazilian place?
Yeah,
it was fun.
He had a dog too. Remember
yeah, yeah,
we went back to his
yeah,
place?
Yeah,
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 yeah, yeah.
Is he married?
Nah.
But
he'd love to see you.
Oh, he's
He'd be
good
so
dude.
Excited to see you.
You guys did a couple big things back then,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
Commercials and stuff.
Yeah.
There's one online.
Yeah, Pepsi.
There's an IBM. No, there's an IBM. I looked it up.
Oh, the Coder Knots.
No.
Campaign.
No, there's one where I'm sitting at a desk. You know what I mean?
Oh, no, you're bald?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You saw it?
Yeah, then you're at the desk and you say something.
But the what? You should we move on?
No, I think it's on Reddit or Facebook.
Yeah. What were we at time?
Past 50.
Past 50.
We are.
Do you know I had a dream last week that Bobby married a Korean girl and I was like, well, where am I gonna go? Like, what do you still want me in your life? He's like, yeah, I do, but like as my servant. So I became like his like maid. And I went to their wedding and I was crying and I was living in the same house still but in a different room, and I was just their maid.
Kiss the maid. Kiss the maid,
you just
Bobby.
Dip. No, I will not kiss you. Nope. Right no, now. I will not. That's a rule. You dip, no kiss. No. 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 No.
Kiss. All right. So, guys, that was a weird podcast. But you know what? I liked it at the end.
Can we go into a couple of questions people want to ask all of you? They're not unhelpful advice questions.
Yeah. I'll answer any question right now, man.
Okay, right now. Someone asked, this guy asked a bunch of random questions to all of us. Danny Fascio, he asked one of his questions out of 50 questions is, if you could visit any era in time, what timeline would you travel to and why? Steve?
Dude, that's not a good one.
Can I change ethnicities?
Yes, you can be
let's
anything.
Let's add that.
Because if I have to stay Korean in short, there's not a lot of options.
Yeah.
Oh, I want to go to the 1800s.
Circus.
No, it's like then all of a sudden I'm working on the railroads.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like, oh, I wanted to visit, you know.
What about the time period of like the Game of Thrones?
Oh, that'd be cool.
No, wait, is that a natural time period?
I don't know. No. It's another dimension. Let's just make it happen.
No. But if I can change ethnicities, I would probably still be in like the late 60s, probably in San Francisco. Mm-hmm. A white dude, good looking. You could fuck everybody. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? You can do all the drugs in the world.
70s for me. The
70s. Yeah. Why the 70s?
It was because like cool music and.
Like New York, Brooklyn, 70s. Yeah.
And as a cool. Korean?
No.
What was the deal with Koreans in the 70s?
I don't know much about it.
I don't think that our people in America got respect until like in the last 15 years.
70s.
Mm. I would want to go back to probably 400 years ago in the Philippines so I could be like Lapu-Lapu and be the one to kill Magellan.
Whoa.
I want to be, the female Lapu-Lapu, and I would sit there in shallow water. And he would walk over and not see me, and I would just fucking put a stake through him.
Is that Colin? No.
Did
you just pull up a picture of an old white guy?
No, it's just Colin Drake. I'm just looking, trying to find Colin Drake.
And I would
was that Colin?
I would stop colonialism.
I love if you just want to change history.
Yeah.
Colin wants to make like changes. Another question is, how do you guys overcome nervousness?
I don't.
Oh, my God. Let me just say something about that, okay? I'm going to say something about that. You just do it. Like, today, I swear to fucking God, I'm shooting Love. I said this already. And Gelman and Gillian have a scene. And the scene is killing. It's such a great, meaty scene where they're getting laughs. You know what I mean? Dramatic, crying. And then I have to go in and say one line at the end, and it's like they only added me. I shouldn't even been in the scene, really. And I was so nervous, but I went in the room anyway. It's just, what are you going to do?
And did you're fuck there. Up?
I fucked it up, yeah.
How many times until you
about
got
five
it right?
Times. And I was like, I looked on the ground. I go, I'm so sorry, guys. Like, it's okay. You know what I mean? But it's like you just have to go for it.
So it's... Short answer: just action through action. Just do the action and don't.
God, guts,
just don't think about the results. You just show up.
Yeah. I also say it helps me when I'm anxious just to say I'm anxious to somebody who is unaware of my anxiety.
You do it.
Hey,
all the time.
I'm nervous. I'm anxious, and that's saying it out loud. Mm-hmm. Almost takes it away from my insides.
I noticed that you say it all the time.
Yeah, because I want you to know what I'm feeling, so that you know you're not surprised.
George, I'm getting anxious. Stop reading these emails to me.
Yeah, I say that, right? I'm like, this is my limit. I am getting anxious. I have to go.
And then what are some habits you can do without?
Can't do without? Well, for them, for him, it's smoking.
And this.
Yours is dip.
Have you ever stopped before?
I mean, I'm addicted to this now.
The peeling the skin on the bottom of my left foot.
Well, I used to bite my thumb. Yeah, I quit that.
I peeled the fuck out of the skin at the bottom of my left foot.
Is it raw now?
It's always been raw.
Mm. What's yours, Gilbert?
Picking my butt hair.
Oh, yeah, you're right. We already got it. Yeah, we've already, done
only
this.
During Netflix, though.
Yeah.
Let's not get crazy.
Been there, done that. You know what I mean?
So it's just a...
You just got to pick it up.
Yeah, give me another one.
I can't floss without smelling it.
Share with us an interesting or weird fascination you have that perhaps not many people have in common.
Fascination?
That a lot of people don't have in common.
Yours, Bobby?
I got to think about that. That's a good question.
I have many fascinations.
Share us an interesting or weird fascination you have that perhaps not many people have in common.
Whew. That's a very, like, it actually requires.
I mean, mine's a little dirty, but mine is, I have a theory.
Mm-hmm.
The size and shape of a woman's mouth.
Oh yeah, you've talked about.
Is
that.
Directly proportional to the size.
That
and shape
is
of the
most
vagina.
Bogus bullshit crap I have ever.
So
heard.
What I'll do
that
is
made
I'll
me
look,
just think so much. Now. I'm like,
but you know what you do though? You know what you do is when you're on a date. Not you know I'm with Khalyla forever.
Okay.
But before, what I would do is if I'm on a date, I would just say that to them, right? And then just stare at their mouth all dinner.
What a
and
power
they,
move!
And they do this. They do this.
I don't exactly have a small mouth.
All
does that mean
male...
my vagina is pretty big?
All the young male listeners do it.
It's a gap.
What?
Your vagina.
Don't smile, Clyde. Don't smile. Don't smile. Don't smile. Don't smile. Don't smile. Steve, what do you find interesting?
Well, I'm into like conspiracy theories and all
that.
Oh,
yeah.
What's your latest one? You talked about the other
dimension.
There's
a guy, quasi-luminous. And he's all about like putting your blood over your intent, and he thinks that we're on a flat Earth dome, like there's no space. And
is he a flat earther?
Yeah.
Oh,
well,
God.
He's deep into it. Like he thinks that we need to go to Mount Meru, and like there's this portal out of this existence. Like this is like we're on a grid thing, like a matrix grid. It's like crazy. Yeah, so
Mount Meru, where is that?
Meru exactly. is that. You watch a documentary about that.
Oh, yeah, Meru.
Remember, it's Mount almost Meru. Like.
Well, let's go.
But he says you have to spill because it's like if you spill, because you know how like satanic groups, they blood sacrifices for evil intent, but we could reverse it if we spill our blood to bring good on this planet. Like you're
so how do we get to the portal? We go to the
Mount
Meru.
Well, you're supposed to, on a piece of paper, I guess, like shed your blood and write, I intend to bring heaven on earth or something like that.
And then
this guy's deep into it, though.
So,
like,
so you take
I watch
this,
it
no,
just as I'm fascinated.
You go to Mount Meru, you write a blood letter.
Yeah, and, you're
and then a portal.
No, there's, it's like this, you're supposed to, there's an exit out of this matrix some, according to him. I don't know. I don't know much about it.
It's crazy. It's not even crazy. It ain't motherfucking real, dog. Okay? It's a waste of time. Why would you fucking sit there and watch that shit?
I don't know. It's interesting.
It is interesting.
I think it's interesting.
To possibly believe that this is there's more than one dimension, that's absolutely interesting.
Do you believe that?
No, I like watching stuff like that.
Like you saw Interstellar, right?
Yeah.
Do you think something like that exists?
Yeah, something like that. Mm. That's a good movie, actually. I like that. I like Interstellar.
And the last one... where is it? Do you think you live in a great state within the U.S.? How could it be better? That was his last one.
I think it's the best place. I've been all over the country. I personally cannot see myself living anywhere else. It's like-minded.
California.
Yeah.
I just like that it's all colors of the rainbow here, and it's very, it's like, not one is a majority. It's like there are as many Koreans as there are whites, as there are blacks, as there are Mexicans, and it feels very comfortable for me to have that much diversity.
Yeah, because I was, you know Paula Pell, she was a writer at SNL,
mm-hmm.
like for 30 years, but she's on Love, right?
Mm-hmm.
And we're sitting there with Brett and her and I, we're like in the holding room or whatever, and this lady is like, in terms of comedy, a beast. Like just in terms of legend, like, you know, like, Judd Apatow like respects her and stuff, and she's beautiful. She's probably in her 50s or whatever, maybe. I don't know how old she is, but you know, to bring up, you know, I'm not gonna get into politics, but I just know that if I just bring it up, that she's gonna be like minded,
mm-hmm.
right? So she's like, and then Brett, and then Gillian, and you can talk about, you know what I mean? How as liberal, I just know that they're liberal,
mm.
right? And I don't want to live in a fucking place, just for me, where I can't talk about stuff like that and find allies. Mm. You know what I mean? It's like, because if you're in Texas, you don't know. So, that's all.
You also can't set off on your own island and pretend like opposing ideas don't exist, because you're never going to get to a common ground.
You've said that to me before. you have. And I don't know if I agree with you, but let me journey through my life to see if I can come to that conclusion. Boom. Okay. That was a weird Tiger Belly, huh?
No, yeah, we haven't gotten to the unhelpful advice yet.
I thought those were it.
No, those are just questions.
Oh. Unhelpful advice with Bobby, Khalyla, and Steve.
This is from Matt. Hey, guys, I found myself to be really serious and stuck up lately, and it's making me confused about my social life a lot. I'm wondering, how can I be funny and laid back like Bobby, Khalyla, or even Steve?
Wait, I flagged a better question.
You want that one?
Yeah.
The longer one?
Wait, we can answer that one, too. Because I'm confused about that
How
question.
Old is he? No age.
Well, that would have a lot to do with it.
Or if he's just really serious and stuck up, late, he's making me confused about my social.
But
I think he's listening to our podcast.
Be chill.
Be chill, man.
Yeah. Don't take things too seriously. Stuck up. I don't know what stuck up
like
means.
Like hubris, maybe, George? What do you think, Steve?
I don't know. Just chill out.
Chill the fuck out. Yeah.
Honestly, just like, just chill out. Don't be
Stop
so
being
weird.
Stuck up. Yeah. Like. That's a bad thing to be, a stuck
oh,
up.
Also,
like,
real quick, I've been playing Ruzzle a lot now against people. Mm-hmm. So if you play Ruzzle, and you can message and stuff, but play me. It's under Bobby Lee Live. Find me on Ruzzle, and I'd love to play you in it.
Okay.
I cannot make announcements like that.
You can.
Yeah, cool.
I'll give me the other flagged one now.
You want the flagged one? All right. This is it the high school junior?
What's it about?
I don't have anything. Christian Fox News? Coming out? No?
I flagged it because it was actually a decent question.
There's a bunch flagged.
What do you got to plug right now, Steve? Let's,
Steve.
Okay, yeah. Well, on, was it every Tuesday?
Every Tuesday.
Yeah, I got my own podcast. So it's under YouTube, Steebee Weeby.
Yeah, Steebee Weeby.
Yeah, I do a puppet show called Lil Ray's World at the end, and I'm trying to get guests.
I love that, by the way.
Yeah, so I'm doing doing songs too with the puppet show. Is there anything I'm missing? We're trying to get guests too. So check it out. Yeah.
Cool. All right. So back to the question, guys.
This is a good one.
This is from Throwaway. Hey guys, I'm a high school junior from Texas, and recently my fear of coming out to my parents as a gay has really been fucking with me mentally. It may not seem like a big deal, but it's important to understand that my parents are Christian, Fox News watching, Trump trained type who think being gay is a choice and would likely disown me if they found out. To make matters worse for myself, I'm not really effeminate in any way, so coming out would come as a complete shock. In an old episode, you guys briefly talked about how having similar conservative parents would make hypothetically coming out extremely difficult. Do I wait until I'm out of the house and let them know from a distance, or do I cut ties with them completely before they cut ties with me? Thanks for the advice. Very conservative parents.
It's a tough one.
Wants to come out. Not effeminate like me.
I would wait to get out. I wouldn't tell them now.
Yeah.
But also, if you feel it urgent and you need your freedom today, it is your right to say it today. But if you're okay with possibly
getting kicked out.
There's a documentary called The Bible Told Me So. Mm-hmm. It's a really good documentary about that exact topic. Mm-hmm. And in some cases, and a lot of these people, it's all revolved around extremely religious families, mm-hmm. right? So one guy became the first ordained priest or whatever in the United States, and his parents are just completely supportive, you know? Mm. There's another story of a woman who is really religious. Her daughter said she was gay, and then the mother disowned her. And they would fight about it, like they would write letters, you know? And then the daughter hung herself in a closet and died. And now the mother, her whole life is revolved around speaking out against, mm. you know what I mean, religions that, you know, oppress because she feels such an immense amount of guilt, you know? And she realized that it's an old, really fucked up way of looking at homosexuality, mm. you know? I just think that the reason why I'm being real is that I'm not a Christian is because of that single thing of that they believe that
gay people are going to go to hell in a fiery hell forever.
Not all Christians.
I mean, but generally, you know, you go to like any, what's that Harvest Crusade that they have, those gigantic, you know what I mean? Most of them, fundamental Christians, right?
Extremists, probably.
Not extremists, regular ones.
The more hardcore ones, probably. But I'm saying
I mean, you go, yeah, you go to Mosaic. Yeah, yeah, you go to Mosaic on whatever, Fairfax.
I put makeup on.
Right? There, that's, you know what I mean? Anyone can come, yeah. Right? I'm talking about all the religions, Christian religions in America.
This person's question is, he's 16, probably. Get out of the house. Should he wait to get out of the house to come out, or should he come out now?
You know what? I, to be honest with you, what I would do, I'd come out now. Mm. Because you, and I promise you this, even if your parents freak the fuck out and they disown you or whatever it might, the consequences might be, you're still going to be free. Mm-hmm. Okay? And I'd rather be free. I'd rather tell people what I am, that I, this is who I am. There's nothing I can do about it. I can't fake it.
And also, you don't know that it might change their, they might have a change of heart regarding it.
You don't know the reaction.
Yeah, but it could also turn, also expect anything.
Absolutely. Expect everything.
It could go the other way. So I don't want you to think that, oh, I'm going to do it and they're going to be on my side. They could be like, get out of the house.
Except the worst.
But it's better, I mean, what Pryor said in his book, the truth will set you free.
Also though, but prioritize your safety. If you're in a super thick like Bible Belt area and you think coming out is unsafe for you, I'd say wait until you get out.
That's the only circumstance. If you think that you're gonna die from it, don't do it.
Yeah, but if you're in California somewhere, come out, you know,
move to California.
Yeah. Is that it?
Yeah. So Steve, want to plug it one more time, say all your things, your Instagram.
Oh yeah, just Instagram Kwangu, Kwangou, and then got my Steebee Weeby show on YouTube, right, George? Yep.
Check it out. It's funny.
It's really good. It's really funny. I love it.
Say that again, George.
You say it.
Steebee.
Spell your name.
Oh, Steebee.
But next time, pick a longer handle.
Why
sure.
did you do that?
Pick the longest handle possible, please.
Why do you think it's so difficult for people?
You could even say your own show name.
Yeah, yeah.
Steebee Weeby. The Steebee Weeby Show.
Steebee. What the? Slep King, any shows?
No. No but shows. Let's not plug anything. But we also have something that we want to say, right?
That's at the end.
Not okay. Yeah.
You guys can leave for a second. We're going to do some housekeeping.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. I'm going to take the 10-day. Guys, say bye, Steve.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Thank you, Steve.
Yeah.
Steve, you're awesome, man.
Is that a weird one?
No,
it's not. We're still recording, too, man.
Okay.
Don't worry about it.
You're a great man.
I didn't think we'd talk about Colin.
Guys, but you gave a shout-out to a legend in Hollywood.
Yeah.
Colin Drake all day.
People forget about all these Hollywood stars from the 20s and whatever.
Do you mind closing the door when you leave, Steve, please?
Welcome to TigerBelly Housekeeping with your host, Khalyla and Gilbert and Pink Dick. George, hashtag the ghost. Hashtag
damn it.
Has a pink dick.
I think it's a very bold move to wear pink when you're already pink.
What did I say to you when I saw you outside? I was like,
pfft. Oh, pink's my color. I saw Pamela Anderson once in high school wearing pink, and I was like, we're similar skin tones. Maybe I should start.
So you basically want to look like you don't. You're not wearing a shirt. Is
and
what you're
you
want to
fuck Kid Rock. Also, I've never heard a high schooler male go, me and Pamela Anderson have the same skin tone. Usually, it's I want to fuck Pamela Anderson.
Well, yeah, I did have a poster in my
okay,
in got my locker.
You know that I've been to three Kid Rock shows.
You?
I know, it's crazy.
Wow, I would not expect.
Because it's this is going to sound really strange, but his shows are actually, I wouldn't go to one now. I realize where he stands on this whole.
Well,
like,
just look at him as a performer.
He's a good performer. Yeah. And this is, you know, when, yeah. It was
and
a weird
his country
time.
Phase, his country phase was good.
I used to live in Vegas, and Vegas got to me for a few years. I ended up seeing three Kid Rock shows.
For some reason, I would think of you as more like hip hop and like electronica and that kind of thing.
Don't ever put me under a category.
A label? What are you?
I listen to everything.
I thought you were going to be like, I'm millennial.
I'm
millennial. I hate labels. I'm a millennial. I hate labels.
Oh, God. A millennial. People say that. A millennial is the biggest
I've
fucking
I actually
label.
Heard someone go, I'm a vegan, but like I hate labels, but I am a vegan.
Yeah.
I'm like, fuck off. You're Satan.
Oh,
you love anybody who's a vegan loves talking about being a vegan. How
but they hate labels.
Yeah.
George, any announcements?
We just have one ask this week, guys. If you have just a few minutes, could you go to podcast.study? Just give us a little bit of information of who you are and everything else there. It'll help us out a lot. We just want a couple hundred.
Honestly, just to know who the demographics are.
Yeah.
Because we know who you guys are. A lot of your faces from Instagram and Twitter and all that stuff.
We have a good idea of what our audience looks like.
Mm-hmm.
But this will just give us an even clearer idea, just a small little sample population so we can better navigate through future podcasts
promotions and
sponsorships
like
and things like that. So,
and if we get enough people after this one, we won't have to ask you next week. So once again, podcast.study and be one of the good ones that keeps us from.
So what do they have to do? Go to podcast.study and then.
Yeah, it's just a couple simple questions about who you are and then what podcast you listen to. It's just a click and...
But how would they know that it's coming from us? Would they have to enter...
They'll click on which podcast they listen to. So you can they can click on whatever podcast, other podcast they listen to.
Got it.
Cool.
But yeah, be sure to click on TigerBelly. That's all we ask.
Okay.
And then... Sanebox again, if you want to... Clean up your inbox, sanebox.com/TigerBelly.
And that's sanebox.com/TigerBelly.
You have
go clean out your mailbox.
You have an insanely accurate broadcasting voice.
That I feel also that broadcasting voice is dead. Unless you're Howard Stern and you're running the whole game, but no one does that anymore. Do they?
Yeah.
Or, no.
It makes me uncomfortable when people don't use fluff words, when they're so professional and crisp about it.
No likes, no uhs.
It doesn't sound, it doesn't come off as genuine.
Speaking of, here's a fun fact. If you're a longtime listener, I think we should admit it. There was a time, maybe in the first three episodes, we used to edit out fluff words. Then we realized.
What?
Yeah.
We did it. We would have a lot of long, especially with me, because I just go by what's at the front of my head.
Yeah.
And I would have long moments of thinking and just looking up at the air and looking super tanga.
Yeah, classic tanga.
Tanga, very tanga. Tanga is like this, George. Like when you're just spacey,
you're
a space cadet.
Can you ditch the camera so someone can draw?
This is tanga.
But yeah, but then we realized it's fucking a podcast. We didn't go to school for radio and broadcasting, and it's just it's more real when you just talk.
I also, if I had to be professional and I had to be a proper broadcaster, I wouldn't be doing this.
Yeah.
I'd get fucking fired on the first day.
Hey, Khalyla, pack your things.
Exactly. Are
your
you kidding me?
Your face is killing the show. Khalyla, any announcements?
No, absolutely not. Other than I went lobster diving again at night. And
without
I was an utter failure. I could
fucking
not.
Fucking flashlight.
I could not. Okay, so it's very different when you dive during the day than at night. And I hadn't.
What's the difference? Khalyla, what's the difference?
Well, for starters, I didn't have a nightlight, and Jessica had. It was the only light that we had, so I was tracking wherever direction she was putting the light. You know, and it's like 10 p.m. You're out
so
in the middle
like
of the ocean,
cat, like running around chasing the.
And so when I would surface and I would look around me, I had no sense of. Like, you can't be like, oh, there's the beach right there.
Mm-hmm.
There's an island there, or there's a boat there. There's just ocean around you, so you get very disoriented.
Oh, that's scary.
So it's like pitch fucking black, and so, oh my God, George, I have never vomited so much into an ocean. I was so seasick and so, because I just lost complete orientation in the middle of the ocean. It just like came out of me like a fucking
seasick
fountain.
In the ocean?
Yeah, you can get seasick.
Just from swimming?
I fucking dare you to go out there and not vomit.
Fuck you, George Kimmel. Hashtag you ghoster. I'm still upset from that the other day. Hashtag George the ghost.
Khalyla, hashtag Khalyla vomits. Khalyla ceased to exist. Oh, God damn it.
Wait a second. I do something extreme in the middle of the night and I vomit, and that's unbelievable to you?
Hashtag extreme Khalyla. Let's get something. Let's get other hashtags out there.
I just wanted to fucking feed the family some lobster, and you're going to shit on my experience?
Question. How many lobsters in total did you get?
I grabbed two antlers.
Great stuff.
Antennas, I mean.
Wow. People.
They regenerate. It's okay. I was just an utter failure because I fucking vomited, and Jessica probably could have gotten a lot more, but I was like, duh, I'm not feeling good.
Oh, no.
So I'm a failure. But the season doesn't end until March 22nd, so I still have time.
She still has a chance, guys. Speaking of food, is there... I don't know why I said speaking of food. Is there a way to promote that one thing we're looking at, your Bobby's friend? The
Kobe?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. So another announcement. Every week we're going to try to announce this. You can go to nation-foundation.org and you can donate to this organization that helps kids in Uganda get scholastic materials and all the things they need.
Yeah, I don't know. Speaking of food, Kobe beef. Help kids in Uganda. I was like, what?
Not a laughing matter, Gilbert.
It's not serious, guys.
Poor choice.
Yeah. Classic Bobby.
But that's all I have. You can find me on all forms of social media at Calamity K. That's K-H-A-L-A-M-I-T-Y-K.
Yeah, let's get her verified, guys.
Also, if you haven't already, you guys have been killing it with leaving us reviews on iTunes.
Oh,
our goal is still 1,000 reviews. And it will pad our egos a little bit, but it gives us a little bit of a boost, and
we just need
to get to that 1,000. Every little bit of your support helps.
Mm-hmm. And make sure you follow us on TigerBelly at TigerBelly on Instagram and on Twitter at TheTigerBelly, and email us any questions or concerns or secret love notes to George Kimmel at TheTigerBelly@gmail.com. That's our show, guys. Bye.
Bye. Oh shit, I was thinking. I lost my brain.
Let's all do it one more time. Let's all do the face. And then 3, 2, 1. Bye.